Hello, welcome to my channel once again. I don't know whether you've already watched a video of a group of guys who have decided to travel by road from Nigeria to Senegal. And as you know, if you are someone who has been watching my videos, you know that I'm currently in Sierra Leone, you see. And whilst they are on this trip, I met them, or I saw them in Sierra Leone. So basically what I'm trying to do now is to talk to them and also ask them about their experience, basically traveling from Nigeria through Benin to Togo, Ghana, Cote d'Ivoire, Liberia, and now they are in Sierra Leone. So let's talk to them and know or get to hear their experience. Charlie, let me know.
Okay.
No, straight away like that. It's a vlog.
So
let me know. What actually came into your mind for you to decide that you want to travel along this West African? Because sometimes, Charlie, we hear a lot of things, the borders.
Yeah.
It's very crazy.
Yeah, you know, earlier this year,
yeah,
I tried the one in East Africa.
Okay.
You know, as a Ecowas citizen,
yeah,
trying the East African borders.
Yeah.
It wasn't that difficult.
Okay.
So from there I got the idea that okay, we can actually do this in Ecowas, which is more, because East Africa, I needed visa to cross each border.
Okay.
But here, if I don't need visa, which means it should be much more easier. So we came up with the idea, let's do it.
Okay.
Guess what?
Mm-hmm.
We started doing it, but I can tell you, it's full of stress. Because I find it easier traveling in East Africa as a West African citizen than traveling in West Africa, because all our borders are full of corruptions. Yeah, I'm telling you the truth, because especially most of these French speaking countries and Ghana.
Yeah.
Ghana border is full of corruption, because those guys, I think that's why we should be paying 5,000. And one thing about Ghana border is that they don't collect CDs. They insist on collecting CFA, because I don't know whether they feel that CFA is getting momentum or something. I don't know why.
Ah, okay.
They keep collecting 5,000. Entering Ghana, we paid 5,000 CFA.
CFA.
Which is a lot of money.
Yeah.
To enter Ghana.
Yeah.
Leaving Ghana, we have been made to pay. Guys, don't mind this rain, because we are in Sierra Leone. It's really not away from Liberia. Every day rains. So leaving Ghana, they still insist that we'll pay 5,000 CFA for them to later. Okay, we'll pay.
And that's like equivalent.
50 Ghana cedis, yes. To leave Ghana.
Ghana. Okay, okay.
So for them to stamp. So I was wondering, why can't ECOWAS issue us visa?
Yeah.
So that we don't pay for a visa, because if you ask me what do I pay for to enter Ghana, I would not tell. I don't know. We are supposed to be ECOWAS citizens.
Yeah.
There are free movement, which is why we wanted to make the travel to also show people the free movement of the ECOWAS borders.
Yeah.
But doing that is not possible, because you keep paying. Just as if you're paying for visas. You understand? But if we say, okay, ECOWAS citizens, pay for visa, we can make an account of what we are paying for. You understand?
Yeah.
So that we'll not be clueless. You say, okay, well, I paid 5,000 CFA to enter Ghana.
That's
so what is the money for?
Yeah.
I can't tell. You understand, the corruption is just too
it's
much.
It's too much. It's too
and again,
much.
When you're going into Abidjan, you say Cote d'Ivoire.
Yeah.
After paying for the whatever, 5,000 CFA.
Yeah.
They was okay. They want to search your bag. It's okay. Okay, no problem. They say if they wanted to search your bag, you should pay 1,000 or 500 CFA. We'll be like, no problem. Search our bag. Then intentionally, they want to delay you, so you pay that 5,000 by all means.
Meaning it's the money that they want.
The money that they want. So why do we keep paying? This should be an ECOWAS free movement. But I can tell you from experience, there's nothing free about this movement.
Oh,
yeah? So
okay.
Can let my guy speak more.
All right, Afam, I want to know from your own perspective. Kenneth has actually shared his experience. But from your own perspective too, traveling from what's the name, Nigeria, and now you are in Sierra Leone. What has been the experience?
Okay, before I even talk about that, you know, let me just take you from the top.
Let me come.
Yeah. Okay. Uh-huh. So let me take you from the top.
Okay.
You know, first and foremost, he actually came up with the idea. You understand? And then he put the idea out there. Okay. And then I was like, okay. I've been toying with the idea of actually traveling around along the coast of West Africa. You understand? So since I saw that he was actually, you know, he wanted to do it, I thought, okay, it makes sense. This is probably the best time to go about it.
Okay.
And, you know, I did my findings, did my research. And to be honest, most of the things we experienced, like he has stated, are things that I actually saw. So me, I was ready. You know, I was ready for anything. And it was bad, to be honest. You know, apart from the money you pay at every border.
Yeah.
You understand, which is illegal.
Yeah.
But, you know, they say when something goes on for too long, it starts looking like it's normal.
It's normal, yeah.
You understand? Anyway, we pay. You understand, but I think where we actually had a lot of problem, apart from paying this illegal money, is when they now attempt to make you pay, you know, so that they won't search your bag.
Okay.
You understand? Obviously, they need the money.
The money.
You understand? So even when you tell them that you don't want, that you want them to search your bag, you know, they intentionally delay you. You know, they take it slowly. Yeah. You know, they check it, and then when they see something as little as paracetamol.
Yeah.
You understand? They say you can't enter the country.
Ah, but that's a drug, like, very, very popular. Everybody knows paracetamol.
Yeah, it actually happened to us. You understand? It was actually very surprising. And I think that's the border we had the most problem, which is the Ghana-Cote d'Ivoire border.
Ghana-Cote d'Ivoire border, okay.
Yeah, that's the border we had the most problem. So, it's not been easy, you understand? But the experience has been, you know, has been worth it.
Yeah.
You understand? Currently, we're in Sierra Leone and we have about four more countries
to go. Yeah.
You understand? And, you know, it's a great experience and, you know, everything has been fine apart from the border issues. Yes, we've learned new cultures and so on.
Apart from the border, whatever scam, or I call it scam or call it corruption.
Extortion.
The other worst country we regretted ever going to was Liberia. Jesus.
I wanted to ask that question.
Bro,
sorry
to cut you.
Yeah.
If I forget. There are over 20 offices. In the border alone, they were taken to more than 7 offices.
Uh-uh.
And each office they will tell you, register.
Register what?
I don't know. Then after stamping you, register. Register. Even when after doing the registration, after everything, you will still left the border. On the way, they will stop you. You will see like two people sit down here.
Yeah.
Another sit down here. Another person over there. So this one will say, register. You register. They say you pay.
Register, yeah,
you
for pay what? 200, you know, like 200, when you are registering for something.
I don't know.
You should know.
You pay 200 LD. That's Liberian dollar.
Uh-huh.
And when you're done, the person close by will also say, register. You register. If you say you don't have money, they will keep you there illegally.
Yes,
because it's a country. No friend. They're not even friendly to a Ecowas citizen. Then after registering, the other person who is behind them, who is meant to be searching your bag, will say, register. I said, bro, search our bag. Let's get
Africa.
Out.
It's just crazy.
Search our bag. You say, no. Register. You have to pay money again. We keep registering. What are we registering for? We can't even tell. After getting our stamp.
Oh, Lord.
Is there no other way for these guys to make money instead of extorting people? There's nothing that, like I said earlier, bro, it's crazy. No, we've seen something like this before, but we never knew it's going to be of this magnitude. But it was too much.
Alright guys, we need to call that because of so many noise. I hear those guys speaking pidgin.
Yeah.
You hear Nigeria and Ghana, they speak almost, and Cameroon, I guess.
Yeah.
So like I was saying about Liberia, after stamping you into Liberia, the extortion never ends. They keep asking you to register. Their best word is register. Register.
Register. And each registration costs money. I don't know what you're registering for. Even the one who wants to search your bag, they say register. What are you registering for? Search bag, let's get out. Say register. So for them to use their pen, you have to pay for it. And the worst of the worst part, there's no best, as in the worst of it all, is even Nigeria. We have to pay to even leave Nigeria. You don't know? We have to even pay money at the Nigerian border in Seme. Between Benin Republic and Nigeria.
Nigeria,
we also have to pay those custom people, those immigration, to stamp us out of Nigeria. That's the that's how worse
and how
this ECOWAS movement, how corrupt this thing is. So I don't know why. I think the best, because I have traveled almost, I have traveled almost all the countries in East Africa. I've gone all the way from Kenya, South Sudan, Uganda, Rwanda, Burundi, Tanzania, all those countries. Apart from their visa, nobody asks you money to for stamping or extort you. But in West Africa, you talk about extortion.
Extortion, intimidation, corruption. So instead of let's ECOWAS issue West African citizens, let us issue us visa, we will pay gladly. Even the money is a little bit higher, let us pay. So we know what we're paying for. Leave the road. So we know what we're paying for. Afam, you can add to this, man.
Yeah, to be honest, yeah, I said it all. You know, the West African borders, I think ECOWAS needs to do something, because it's pointless being part of ECOWAS and still going through this stress.
Stress.
You probably go through the same stress that someone from East, South, Southern Africa, Northern Africa, or any part of the world will go through, even as a West African indigenous. You know, so I think ECOWAS needs to actually do something, because there's no country that is left out in all of this. Like he said, we have to pay to leave our own country, Nigeria.
Imagine.
Paid in Nigeria, Benin, Togo, Ghana, Cote d'Ivoire, Liberia, Sierra Leone. Every country we paid.
And if you insist not to pay, they will not let you in. So what's the essence of
having free movement in ECOWAS? It should be, oh my God.
I feel like that is also the reason why even this, recently this, coup that started happening in West Africa, especially. Some of these countries have actually decided to leave ECOWAS because they feel like they are being controlled, kind of, by the UN or the United States.
It's pointless.
You see, some of these things, because you cannot form an organization and just be redundant.
If you can't enforce the rules, what is the point?
You should do, because, and I feel like the East African organization, they are far doing much better than ECOWAS.
Bro, I spend lesser money traveling East Africa than traveling West Africa. Because East Africa, I already have my mind that, okay, I'm getting visa, $30.
Yeah.
I'm getting visa, $15.
Yeah.
That's just it. And that's just it. Nobody asks for anything again.
Anything
you just
again.
Stamp and go your way.
When you were traveling with East Africans, you understand? When the people we were traveling with, all of them East Africans.
They were East Africans.
Yeah. I understand that it would be easier for them, but was it difficult for you as a West African to cross those
it
borders?
It was, because I had to get visa, just especially when I was going from Burundi into Tanzania. Yeah. It was impossible because of I'm a Nigerian, and Tanzania, their visa list is not friendly with Nigerians.
Yeah.
Okay. You have to apply, get someone over there to get a referral, all those nonsense, long as it. And funny enough, I was traveling with an Indian friend of mine.
Yeah.
Within 5 minutes, the Indian friend got 90 days.
Imagine.
But me, as a Nigerian,
as an African.
I was there for almost 1 hour. They have to extort me for them to give me 7 days to just cross over.
That's crazy.
You understand? That's how worst. You understand? But even at that, I feel
my best country in those countries, just Rwanda.
Okay.
Rwanda does not, you can never see any corruption in their border. Nobody can ever ask you one thing in Rwanda. The visa is free.
Imagine.
Once they go there, once they check, okay, welcome to Rwanda, they check your passport, they check your documents, they are complete.
Everything is valid.
Help, boom, welcome to our country.
Imagine.
Simple as that. If you're leaving, hey, when are you coming back again? Please come back. Boom. Goodbye. Simple as that.
You know, his experience in Tanzania, as bad as it is,
it's
still kind of understandable, because, you know, you need a visa to visit this country. But imagine that same experience in West Africa.
In West Africa, where you don't need a visa.
Just imagine that kind of experience in your own region. You understand? It doesn't make sense. You understand?
I paid more traveling West Africa than East Africa. But I felt that traveling West Africa would be a little bit cheaper. And because then I was traveling my East African friend, we were driving. So when we get their border, they don't even need their passports. They'll show their East African community ID card.
ID card, okay.
You just say, okay, they'll write their name. Mm. Yeah, off they go.
In West Africa, when you are traveling with your ID, like the West African You let me say the ECOWAS card. Man, forget. Recently, I think Stella Chanelli was even talking about that. She said, forget about that card and use your passport.
That was the point. If you cannot enforce rule, dissolve that rubbish, let everybody go their way. So we have in mind that we are paying such amount of money. We will budget for it. Don't make people suffer on the road just because of your extortions. And this is not that it's a secret. It's been happening for years.
Very open. Like when
so you guys
know
about it. So why can't you just do something about it?
It has actually become a norm.
Is that how you guys make your money with your immigrations? Come on, sort that thing out. So far, I'm speaking about these six African countries so far. I'm talking about Nigeria border.
Yeah.
I'm talking about
Ghana,
the Republic.
Benin.
I'm talking about Togo, Ghana. I'm talking about Abidjan, Cote d'Ivoire.
Cote d'Ivoire, yeah.
I'm talking about Liberia, I'm talking about
Sierra Leone.
Leone,
yeah.
You understand? But coming to Sierra Leone, we didn't feel it much because we had to get a driver who helped us. We just paid him.
Okay.
Because we got tired of all those nonsense.
Yeah.
You understand? When you say you don't have money, which is your right, they will get into a fight with you. All these officers, they will start intimidating you with their guns.
Which should
not be so. So I'm talking about these six African countries, but so far we still have a Guinea-Conakry, we have Guinea-Bissau, we have the Gambia, we have Senegal. And we are hoping that this country will be nice to us. Because we can't keep doing all these things. It's so crazy, man.
It's just crazy. It's just crazy.
Yeah, if you want to hear more stories, want to see this journey, check out our channel. My channel is Kenneth Mwache. You can also check my friend channel over here.
Up from OG.
I will make sure I put their links below for you to go and check some of their videos out.
Yes.
Okay.
Wish us a safe trip to Senegal. Once we get to Senegal, once we relax, we will now tell you guys our experience traveling
experience,
to help enable you to travel better. You understand? Because that's one of the best reasons why we're doing this trip. You understand? To help to get you informed.
Exactly.
So when you decide to make this trip, because this trip should be easy.
It should be easy.
A thing of fun. When I was traveling in East Africa, it was so fun because we were even driving. So We plan to drive on this trip.
Yeah.
But I can assure you, that is the best decision we'll make not to drive.
Mm-hmm.
If we were driving,
it would have been hell.
It would have been hell on earth.
Times 10 of what we experienced.
Yes. I just thank God we made our research properly, and we decided not to take our car on the road. Because if we have taken that car, we might even be in Ghana by now. You understand? We might even be in Ghana by now. I saw Joel Felix.
Yeah.
He was coming from Ghana to Nigeria. He couldn't even get to Nigeria. He had to turn back to run back. So I was like, maybe he didn't do it properly. We watched all the videos. We were trying to make our research. We were like, okay, maybe he didn't do it properly. But I can tell you, everything that guy said in his video from
it's
Ghana
true.
To Nigeria is true.
True, 100% true.
So if we were driving, we would have even suffered more than he suffered.
Jeez.
So I see no point saying that we are this one, where nothing is working.
But okay, saying all the bad things, I'm very sure when it comes to this particular trip, you had some favorite countries that out of the countries that the six countries that you have actually visited.
Yeah.
At least you have some favorite countries. So let us know which ones were your favorite.
To be honest, most of the countries were fine. You understand? Yeah. From Benin, Togo.
After the borders.
Yes, there were good things about every country.
Yes.
Okay.
You understand? Although, and I hate to say this, the one country that, you know, I don't know, maybe it's because of how we came, when we came, or whatever. You understand? Liberia. Liberia was very tough. Like we told you earlier,
we got
the
depressed.
Borders, is actually where it started. You know, they extort you all over. And then when you get into the country, you understand? I don't know, there's just something about, you know, how we got into Liberia. You know, it wasn't easy for us.
Okay.
You
know, we nearly got depressed in Liberia.
And Liberia is somewhere we had high hopes for because they were having their independence.
They were rushing.
And we're rushing to get there so that we can celebrate their independence. But, you know, it didn't turn out the way we thought
expected.
You understand? But, you know, every country was good. Ghana was good. You know, Togo, you know, Benin, Cote d'Ivoire.
Yeah.
You know, Cote d'Ivoire is probably the most beautiful West African city.
Yes,
Abidjan, the capital.
Yeah.
City, you understand?
Arguably.
Sierra Leone, we are calling it Sierra Leone now, you know. It's a cool country, the people are friendly, you know, so there's always something positive
about
every country.
Every country, okay.
I intend to go back to Liberia.
Okay.
Second chance.
Yeah, to give it a second chance.
Second chance.
Because I believe that maybe it's just because of how we went.
Yeah.
You know, and where we went.
And maybe the time.
Register.
Yeah.
Yeah. But to like what you said, every country have good things about them.
Yeah.
But yeah, you know, apart from that, some countries also were very special.
Yeah.
Because a country like Ghana was so special because we got so comfortable living in Ghana. We didn't even want to leave. Living was more like a punishment because we felt that the country is so far, so I can tell you, you see Ghana, you see Sierra Leone, because it's mushua, it's nothing, it's normal. Whenever we feel comfortable, we tend to stay longer.
Longer, okay.
In Ghana, we stay almost 1 week. All this other country was like 2 days, 1 day. Even Liberia, only 1 day, we ran away.
Fly from the country.
Understand? Yes. But Ghana, we spent almost a week because we felt so comfortable. It's like we are in Nigeria. Everything was just, people were friendly. Nobody's hostile.
Yeah.
Then, normally, I've been in Ghana before.
Yeah.
So coming back again was, everything felt so at home.
At home, yeah.
Apart from Ghana, Sierra Leone.
Okay.
We've been in Sierra Leone for almost 8 days now.
Yeah.
That's because we feel comfortable being in Sierra Leone.
Yeah.
You understand? The people, the food, everything, the language. That's the Creole. Everything just feels so relaxed.
I can actually attest to that because, man, they are so free. They are, like, they are so free.
So it's not any country, any of this country that will feel so comfortable. We tend to stay longer, which is like I said, that Ghana and Sierra Leone so far.
Yeah.
But other countries, we still have 4 countries ahead of us.
To go.
And we tend to have fun. If we feel comfortable, we'll stay longer.
You understand?
It's something mushua. So for other countries, especially those French country, those Abricots, man, you get to go and retrain your officers. They are so hostile and they are so rude. They don't have to treat foreigners and they get so pissed that just a little thing. You ask for bread, let's go half, you get pissed. Is it alright to get, am I paying your salary? Am I your government? It's so annoying. You ask for salary, you ask for corruption, bribe, you don't have, you get so pissed and get very hostile. What is that for?
That's Africa crazy, for you. Man. That's Africa for you. And the sad thing is, they don't do it to the whites. They don't do it to
like
the white
masters.
They feel so comfortable to do it to we the black people than doing it to the white
that's
people.
Crazy, man.
Man.
But so far so good, man. We are enjoying the trip so far because everything was predicted.
Yeah.
You understand? It is Africa.
Yeah,
but it shouldn't Africa. Be like that. It shouldn't be like this. We've watched like countless videos on this trip before coming on this trip. So they keep complaining. So I thought we were going to see it easier. But my friend,
it's actually the same.
It's not. It's the same. So we wish it can be better. So we are still traveling. Check out the journey. Kenneth Mwache, YouTube channel.
Yeah.
App OG. Yeah.
Okay, see, I didn't say this. If I'm sure you have been watching their videos and they're actually 3.
Yeah.
But one of them,
we need to make a content in one of the sites.
Okay.
So his kind of content is maybe sometimes you have to go deep into some investigative kind of content. So
okay.
We need to make a very nice content. But I'm sure before we go, he might be here to say hello.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Okay. So guys, thank you so much for watching and see. I've not been consistent, eh? It's all because I'm in Sierra Leone and I'm doing something. I'm sure you've been seeing it in the few videos that I've actually been posting. So I'll be very consistent. Don't worry. You'll see my videos very soon.
Get Kamma Dyn to 10,000 subscribers.
Oh man, like I'll be happy. Oh,
yeah?
At least by the end of this year.
What's in the shop, Charlie?